What was our bet?
The winner of this game win £1,000.
I'm anxious. I'm anxious. I've literally just checked how much this bag is going for, and it's going for about black Chanels. I heard Chanels are quite hard to get hold of. Red Balenciaga t-shirt with the Balenciaga print.
No! No!
You guys are gonna see how much clothes I have. And I do not wear 98% of this stuff. 21, can you do something for me? 21. Can you hit a little rich flex for me? Then 21. Can you do something for me? 21. Drop some bars to my pussy ex for me. Then 21. Can you do something for me? Yes, guys, it's Reese Clark here, and I'm back with another video. It's 2023 now, and I hope you guys are starting to accomplish your goals. I feel like I've been slacking on YouTube, but this year I'm gonna go absolutely crazy, and I'm gonna be dropping a load of content for you guys. So make sure you smash that subscribe button, so any video that I bring out, you'll see it straight away. Because last year, in 2022, I had a brilliant year. But looking back, I didn't really document any of it. And I know you guys really want to see it. So the first one we're gonna be starting with is a closet tour. I'm gonna be giving you guys the opportunity to win MacBooks, to win AirPods, to win shopping spree giveaways. And this is not cap, I've done it before. Just like when I took Marcus shopping, or when I took Neenan to a Chelsea game. Now, if you're a long-term supporter, you're gonna see some of the clothes that I wore in my previous videos. And of course, the new bits which I picked up. Cause I'll be real, I picked up quite a lot. But the truth is, with me, I don't really wear designer on a day-to-day basis. I usually wear things like this. And the reason why is because I like to feel comfortable. Designer doesn't really make me feel comfortable, but it makes me feel a lot better about myself. Now remember to smash the subscribe button, and if you enjoy this video, drop a like and drop a comment with any videos that you guys want to see. Now let's get right into the closet tour. Let's get it. So yesterday, I had a bet with the man behind the camera. What was our bet?
The winner of this game win £1,000.
So we're gonna play this game quickly. Let's see who wins the £1,000. Let's go. So it's come to the last ball and it's currently neck and neck. There's only one ball left, which is the black ball. So you guys can see, this is the angle where I'm about to take the shot. You can see that if I take the shot directly, I hit the left side, there's no way that this isn't going in. I'm anxious, I'm anxious.
Yeah!
Here, bro.
Just take it, take it. Now, guys, he's just missed the shot. It rebounded off here, it hit off here, and the ball went to here. It's crazy. It's a bit tight here, so I'm gonna ask you, am I allowed to bring the ball back to here so I have some sort of angle? Remember, £1,000 is on the line. It's up to you. Let me know. Can I do that?
Yes!
Cool, cool, cool. I got this.
3 hours later.
You suck!
Guys, in life you win some, you lose some. The more you lose is better. You know why? Because you learn from the losses. Take a shot, bro. Go ahead. Go on. Guys, he just missed his ball. I'm telling you, I'm gonna get the shot. Watch this. You guys know about this trick, yeah? The behind trick. This one, I used to do this in the youth club back in the day. Oh, I used to do this in the youth club back in the day. Let's do this. Who's the winner? Who's the winner? As per? Who's the winner? As per? Who's the winner? Don't worry. I take bank transfer or cash. It doesn't matter for me. I don't mind. But we'll sort that out a bit later. Let's go and do the closet tour. So we're now in the closet.
Pause.
And I'm going to let you guys know. Make sure you watch this whole video. Because first, I'm going to be doing everything that's in here. Then I've got another closet. So I'm going to bring all of that stuff into here and show you guys that also. A lot of my stuff isn't actually here, but towards the end of the video, I'll show you guys all my shoes, and then that's the closet tour. Remember to watch the whole video, because at the end of this video, like I said, I've got a massive giveaway for you guys. Now let's get into it. Before we get into this, we're gonna start with this Louis Vuitton bag here. You probably see this on my Instagram. I've literally just checked how much this bag is going for, and it's going for about 7-8K. I think even a bit more than that. So any resellers and them by there, if you wanna come get this from me, cause I don't even really use this, you know where to go. Hit my Instagram. But anyways, let's start with bags. The first bag that I want to show you guys is, of course, this Goyard bag. Now, I've got two Goyard bags. For my personal preference, these are the Goyard bags which are on the smaller end. Into the new year, I'm definitely going to be grabbing the big one. But for now, these are the ones that I'm currently rolling with. And I really, really like them because they are very, very neat. I've got the blue one and I've also got the grey one. Another bag that I have is this Louis Vuitton pouch. And guys, I'll be honest with you, this bag, I never wear it. Like 98% of the stuff that you're going to see today, I don't wear. And the reason why is because I just like wearing comfortable things like this. Nike bits that just look really, really neat. The designer stuff is more for when I'm going out and when designer needs to be worn. But when it's a normal day like this, I'm an entrepreneur and I keep things 100% real with you guys. I wear things like this. I even wear things lower than this. But I'll be real with you guys. You guys are gonna see how much clothes I have. And I do not wear 98% of this stuff. And the reason why is because I adore comfort. Like if I was to get any car in the world, I would go for comfort as opposed to a sports car. And the reason why is because I like luxury. I like the feel of feeling good, you know? I don't really like to show off too much, and that's just my personality and how I am. It may look like I like to show off quite a lot with the clothes that I have and all these things. I'm not really a show off person. But now, let's move on. That's all the bags that I can show you. Actually, I've got another bag here, which is my Louis Vuitton backpack. I got this quite a while ago, maybe like a year and a half ago. It's done me justice, but what I'm looking to do this year also is look to get bags more long-term. So I'm probably gonna go for the Josh backpack, which is the Louis Vuitton Josh backpack. It's black, I'll try to leave an image here. Super, super nice, super, super neat. And if I was to wear it with this fit right here, I will look very presidential, I'll be honest. But yeah, let's move on. So the next thing I'm gonna be kicking off this closet tour with is this Moncler Maya jacket. A lot of you guys probably know me from the orange Maya, which is here, but this black Maya is the Maya that I'm currently wearing all winter and is my day-to-day jacket. Even if I'm just wearing, let's say, a Nike tracksuit, for example, or even some designer jeans like some Amiri's, I'll wear this jacket because it essentially just goes with everything. A lot of you guys, I'm sure you're already like this. The price on this has really gone up, but it's a really nice jacket. The next jacket I'm gonna be showing you guys is my orange Moncler Maya. I'll be honest, this doesn't get much wear, and the reason why is because it is quite bright. I will be wearing it into the new year, I'll be honest, because it is really, really fresh. But yep, this is the Moncler Maya. I know a lot of you guys can probably put some really good fits together. I most definitely can as well, but you'll see a bit later, I've got some really, really nice shoes that can go with this and trousers and t-shirts and stuff. But yeah, I've got some really good use out of this jacket and I really, really like it. Next, we're gonna go back to the 2020 days where I have this Canada Goose Wyndham jacket. It's a really, really nice jacket. And this is the jacket that I wear to make sure I stay warm. Really, really nice, quite basic, but it's good to have in the wardrobe. Now to anybody that has followed me since 2020, for one, I wanna give you my love. The love and the support that you guys have shown me from 2020 when I started this journey, teaching people how to build online businesses, and I've got bigger online and built a bigger presence. If you saw my first video when I wore this jacket, I don't even know what I want you to do, but just know that the love that I have for you guys is incredible. But this is the first jacket, the first Moncler jacket that you guys saw on my platform. I still have it, I still keep it to this day. A lot of the stuff that I have, I don't really sell. But guys, this is a jacket in which brings back a lot and a lot of memories. It will bring back memories for me, and it will bring back memories for a lot of you guys. I have this Moncler body warmer. By the way, at the end of this video, I'm gonna be giving away a few of these clothes that I have. And this Moncler body warmer is most definitely gonna be one of them because I will never wear this again. But I know a lot of you guys may actually like it. So this is something that I used to wear. I really enjoyed it. I got some good wear and tear out of it. But this is the orange Moncler Gillette. Swiftly moving on to this classic Amiri jumper. This jumper I love. Like this is a jumper that I love to wear at home, maybe with some shorts, some essential shorts, some nice long socks. And this goes perfect with it. It's really, really warm and it essentially goes with everything. Black and white go with everything. And the truth is I ain't really got much of black and white. But this jumper is 10 out of 10. It's timeless and I'm sure you guys can see why. Next, I have this Gucci Love Parade Los Angeles jumper. This jumper, I haven't really got much wear and tear out of it, but this is also a jumper which I can wear with some shorts, I can wear with some jeans, and it goes really well, looks really, really neat. In the comment section, let me know what you think of this jumper, but I think it's pretty timeless, you know, and it goes with quite a lot. Next, we're going to move on to two items. Number one, we've got this Dior Oblique cardigan, which is super, super nice. When I'm looking to go out, let's say for a meal, for example, I might put on something like this just to look a bit more suave. But this is a presidential piece, I think. This is a piece where if you're trying to make a statement, this is something that you should put on. And I've also got the shoes to match. And this is very presidential. This is my Mary's. You're going to be looking like the kid. Next, I've got this Amiri shirt. This Amiri shirt is also a timeless piece. It's quite colorful. Normally timeless things are either black or white, more time black. But I believe this is a timeless piece because you can see the quality and the shine from this Amiri shirt. When I put this on, guys, I tell you for free, I feel very, very good about myself. I feel very good about myself. With a little watch on the side, some nice jeans, some nice shoes, you can't go wrong. Next, another blast from the past. This Palm Angels tracksuit. Personally, where we are today, 2023, I don't really do Palm Angels. You can see this is super clean. And this is something that I'm going to be giving away at the end of this video. So if you are my size, I am a small to extra small, depends. But if you are looking to win this in the giveaway, this is something that I'm going to be giving away as well. Because it isn't something that I would want to wear, and I haven't really got time to sell it, you know. But this is a timeless piece, and it brings back a lot of memories as well. Next, we have this Dior t-shirt flooded in the Dior print. And this t-shirt I was actually gifted for my birthday about a year ago. This is most definitely a timeless piece. And again, you can wear this with literally anything. There's also a jumper version of this, but I like the t-shirt a lot more than the jumper. But again, let me know what you guys think in the comment section. When the sun was out and I could wear shorts, this t-shirt and some nice shoes, you know? Next, we have this red Louis Vuitton Rockstars jumper. I'm gonna leave a picture right here from when I took a picture in this jumper. I think this jumper is 10 out of 10. And with me, I pick things that I personally like. And this jumper, when I saw it, I had to purchase it almost straight away. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section, but I think this is a 10-10 cop. Another piece from back in the day, this blue Louis Vuitton Paris t-shirt. And we also have this red Balenciaga t-shirt with the Balenciaga print.
No! No!
One thing about me is I know Balenciaga's cancelled right now. I'm going to be giving this away to anybody that wants it. I wouldn't like to burn it. I'm not really wearing Balenciaga at this current time. But if anybody wants this, you can most definitely have it because I'm not going to be wearing it for now. I've got another Balenciaga tee. I'm not going to be wearing it for now. I've got another Balenciaga tee. If you're in support of Balenciaga, because I'm personally not, giveaways there. Here's another Balenciaga tee. I've got some good wear and tear out of this, but if you want it, you can have it. Next, we've got two really cool t-shirts. Amiri 2022 California, which is super, super nice. It goes really, really well with some beige shorts and even some beige socks. So this was a really good cop. And also this Gucci t-shirt. It's got nothing on the back, but I took a really nice picture in this when I went to Paris for a week. And you can see that this is also another statement piece and looks 10-10. And I'll be honest, the fit on this, like a lot of Gucci t-shirts don't really have good fits, but the fit on this one is absolutely crazy. And if you give me a follow, you'll see me wearing this t-shirt quite a lot. Next, we have this Gallery Depth t-shirt, which is cool. One thing I hate about the Gallery Depth t-shirts is the neck on these Gallery Depth t-shirts, it stretches to the side and down. So I don't recommend it solely because of the fit. And I gave it a wash and it currently feels quite stiff. So I don't really wear this t-shirt. I might wear it if I'm popping to the shop or going for a drive, for example. But this t-shirt, really, really nice. It looks cool, but make sure you don't wash it in the washing machine. Send it to the dry cleaners. Don't make the mistake that I made. Then the next one we have is this Amiri t-shirt. It is clean, it does look a bit crimpled, but I also have the orange one as well, which is in the other wardrobe, which I'll try to show you guys also. You've probably seen it in my other videos, but this plain Amiri t-shirt, the Amiri logo spreaded across the front. Let me know what you guys think. So guys, I've got a lot of t-shirts still in here. I'm not gonna show you guys everything because I don't wanna keep you guys here for too long. And of course, at the end of the video, we will be doing the clothing giveaway. And every time I post, I do £100 giveaways over on my Instagram. So head over to my Instagram and be sure to turn on notifications so you don't miss a thing. So you guys already know my shoe game, I believe, is 10-10. And I've got quite a lot of shoes. I'm going to be showing you guys 7 or 8 pairs in my collection. From the last videos, you already know that I love Lambins and I've got a lot of Lambins. So I'm going to be showing you guys a few of those. I've got some Dior's, Chanel's, Louis Vuitton's, Jordan's, you name it. I've got a lot of shoes, but let's get into this. So the first shoe I'm going to be showing you guys are these Lambins here. These orange Lambins combined with the white, I think they're 10-10. And they go with anything that has orange, like my orange Maya or the orange Gucci t-shirt. That's why I picked these up, and I've got some good wear out of these. The next shoe we have is the reverse color of the orange Lanvins, and this is the blue version with the baby blue and the white. I've also got some really good wear out of these. I wore these quite a lot when I went to Paris not too long ago, but these are 10/10. And I'll be honest, Lanvins are very, very comfortable. Swiftly moving on to the next ones, which are these ones here. You guys may look at Lanvins and think these laces, they look really, really weird. But you must understand, these shoes are very, very comfortable and they are highly recommended. So this is the third pair of Lanvins that I've got. I think I have another one, but they are in the other room. So I'll try to grab those for you as well. But swiftly moving on to the next shoe, which are my black Chanels. I heard Chanels are quite hard to get hold of. I picked these up when I went shopping with Poku Banks about 8-9 months ago, but these are again a timeless piece. I probably wore these about 3-4 times in my life, but these Chanels, classic black, there's nothing to complain about with these. Next, we have the reverse version of the black Chanels, which are the white ones, which are also very, very timeless. And I heard a lot of people are trying to get their hands on these. I also picked these up on the same day I picked up the black ones when I was with Poku Banks, but these shoes essentially go with anything. Let me know what you think about Chanels. Do you like them? Are they a cop? Are they a drop? The next shoe we have are these Dior Oblique trainers. These Dior Oblique trainers, I believe I wore for my birthday at some point, or I remember I went to a meal wearing these, I can't remember where, but I've only worn them once. But shoes like this are 100% timeless, and this will also go with the Oblique cardigan, which I showed you guys a little bit earlier. So if you're trying to make a statement, this is a shoe that I must definitely go for. I also have these black Louis Vuitton trainers with the Louis Vuitton print all around the shoe. They're leather, I've worn these about once, and I personally believe I'm never gonna wear them again. And the white ones are a lot more comfortable. These shoes are very, very stiff. Maybe I need to get more wear and tear out of them. These are a shoe that, wait till the end of the video and I may potentially give these away, because I know for a fact I'm never gonna wear them again. Next, you can probably tell I wear these quite a lot. These are my day-to-day shoes, which are these Louis Vuitton trainers in white. These are 10 out of 10. And I know as we enter the new year, before we touch the 15th of January, I'm going to be purchasing another pair of these. If they start in the Louis Vuitton store or any resellers, be sure to hit me up, because I really like these shoes and I want to get another pair. So I tell you, if you're ever looking to get any Louis Vuitton trainers, these are the ones that you should go for. Forget everything else. These have done me real, real justice. And I absolutely love these shoes. And these are probably the shoes that I like the most in the whole collection. Next, we've got about 4 pairs of BT2s. I do have another 4 pairs, but they are in the storage unit from when I was doing some shooting. So they're in the storage unit. But the 4 pairs that I do have here are these navy blue Dior BT2s here. We have these green and navy BT2s, which I've had for a while. I had these for a very, very long time. These were the first BT2s that I ever bought in my life. BT2s aren't really in fashion. I don't really wear these, I'll be honest. But if I'm popping to the shop or doing something really quickly, I'll put these on because they are quite comfortable for me. I also have the baby blue pair BT2s, which are really in demand when they first came out. But I love this shoe. And out of all of them, out of all BT2s, this is the one that I would say I like the most. And then the final pair, the pair that I like the least, and I will be giving away 110%, are these red, blue, and white, and black BT2s. I don't wear these because I don't want to look like a Superman. And I've worn these quite a lot. So if you are size 6 and you are looking to get some fresh BT2s, be sure to enter the giveaway, because you can most definitely win these ones. Now, that's enough of the shoes that I'm showing you guys. I still have a load of shoes and a load of clothes that you guys can see. What I want you to do is drop a like and drop a comment for part 2, because I still have the same amount of shoes and the same amount of clothes, and I can still make a part 2 to this video. So if you want to see more, be sure to smash the like button, smash that subscribe button, and of course, drop a like. And if you want the opportunity to learn about what I do at the age of 23 to be able to afford all of this and build yourself a consistent income, all you have to do is click the link in the description. This year, I'm going to be super consistent, and this is just a taster of what's to come. Now I'm going to be giving away a few bits. I'm going to be giving away all the Balenciaga t-shirts, my yellow Palm Angels tracksuit, these black Dior trainers here, and a few other bits, which I'm going to be leaving in my Telegram channel. So all you have to do to enter this giveaway is head over to my Telegram channel. But you must follow me on Instagram and Snapchat too, because that's where the winners are going to be announced. In this channel, I'll also be doing £100 giveaways every time I post, plus so much more. Following me on social media can be very, very beneficial to you. Now, you know what to do if you want to earn a consistent income, if you want to win one of the giveaways, and don't forget to smash that subscribe button for more videos. Now, I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll see you guys in the next video. It's Reese Clark, and I'm out. So I was just packing away, and I didn't even realize, guys, this is just, what I just showed you guys is about 10%. These are Amiris, 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 Louis Vuitton. This is new season, so you can ask. Guys, this is only 10% of my clothes that I just showed you in this closet tour. Now, if you want me to finish the closet tour, all you need to do is like, subscribe, and comment on this video. As you guys can see, I've only shown you guys about 10 to 30% of my clothes. I still have a lot more left to show you guys, but I didn't want to give you guys too much at the start. So you know what to do? The giveaway is up and running. 21, can you do something for me? 21. Can you hit a little wrist flex for me? 21. Then 21, can you do something for me? 21. Drop some bars to my pussy ex for me. Then 21, 21. Can you do something for me?